What? Oh, snap. It's so interesting doing these reviews back to back because I caught it. Oh my gosh, dude. Yeah, I might have to do like a spoiler section towards the end of this review. Just because I have to let some of this out. Wow. There's a lot of different things going on in the dynamics of this show. One of the things, when I first started looking at the episode, I was like upset because I felt like the only people that were really grieving was Deanna, her second son, and her husband over the life of their child, Aiden, because Aiden got killed. And I was like, man, what's the deal with the family? You know, like, what's the deal with like the group, you know? Because I saw Rick and Carol talking in the beginning and all, but I was like, well, what's going on? You find out towards the end that each one of them, in their own way, have developed other means of dealing with grief, and each one of them are affected absolutely every single time that somebody dies. And I mean, it's funny because looking at the progression of episode one till now, like, they've built up different walls to be able to deal with the grief that they're dealing with. And it's like, at this point, it was like, man, you could see on, I want to say in this episode, Glenn for sure, Rick, Sasha, almost, I mean, Carol, everybody dealt with it in different ways. But it was funny because what I liked about this episode with Sasha was the fact that you see her in the beginning. Oh, that's Joe, I'm letting him in the door. He's gonna disrupt this in a second, sorry. But what I liked about this episode was with Sasha in it, they allowed her to show like her post-traumatic stress disorder and stuff that she's been really dealing with and harboring up. Because I think that when, in the beginning of the episode, when they had her actually sniping these things, you start to find out that she's embodied some of the things that Michonne has picked up from the tragedy and the loss that she's been dealing with. And so it adds a deeper elevation to her story arc and where it's gonna go. I feel like she's gonna take the same kind of progression like Michonne took. One of the other things that I couldn't believe about this episode was the fact that like Rick and trying to deal with Pete and trying to deal with Pete's wife and trying to deal with the situation, because I guess Deanna knew, and because of that, like, Rick is like, what in the world, you know? And it's even funnier because I saw in the last episode when Carol found out there was abuse going on within the house, and she told Rick, she's like, look, of course I know, like, I dealt with it myself. And it was like, it all went to hell towards the end. Like, Andrew Lincoln did some serious acting, but it was like, everything he's saying is true. It's like, it's true, but it's at a fault because they're trying to embody the semblance of hope of a normalized civilization. And I just don't see it happening. And if somebody does come, like, they would be completely unprepared. But the problem is, when you're trying to do this, you border on lines of the same, what I call the Shane philosophy. Even the fact that how Rick is trying to protect this family and trying to do this, and I can protect your son, I can protect you. I was like, these are the words of Shane. And even like towards the end, it's like, man, like, this is kind of who he's progressed into. And this is crazy to watch. One thing that I really did like too also, that I did talk about last episode, is like how they treated Abraham and Michonne. Last episode, they were dealing with, I think, like Abraham's progression of what he was dealing with, of everything that happened, and being in this new location, and how he's able to rise above it, you know, but at the same time, keep who he is. Michonne equally made this balance when she was going out to try to find Sasha with, what's her name? And by the end of it, like, I think she knows who she is, but at the same time, she can perpetuate being this other semblance of hope, what the town needs. Especially what she did to Rick towards the end. I was like, what in the world? It was just nuts, y'all. I mean, I think that the last episode had more shock factor But this episode, it showed like the seriousness of what's really about to go down. Like looking at this episode, I can tell, like, there will be blood. Like, nobody's gonna come out of this unscathed. And at this point, Deanna has been poisoned by the words of Gabriel, the actions of Rick, and just the situation of the fact that her son is dead. And so, what's gonna happen for the group? I don't know. If they choose to try to kick the group out, what can they really do about it? You know, it's gonna be really interesting. But I think that what helped this episode is what Michonne's action was, and what her realization and revelation of looking at Sasha's life and comparing it to her own. I think that that helped her piece together what she needs to do. Now, I think that there's not anybody in the group that won't do what they have to do, but it is really interesting. Even Carl in this episode, like, he some kind of way is finding himself back to a stage of normalcy, which I really liked with his, kind of, I don't know if you want to call it a relationship with the young girl that's dealing with stuff, but it was really well done. It was really well done. I actually liked this episode a lot better than the first one, just because I guess how it ended and then the revelation I didn't expect, like what's going on with Sasha, what's going on with Rick, what they're really thinking. And I don't know, it was just crazy because towards the end, this is the only spoiler I'll say, the fight at the end, Pete was asking for it. Like, he pushed him, you know? I mean, even if, say he was trying to keep to the laws, like, okay, well, look, just let's go out of town, like, just go and walk away from this until you cool out so you're not drunk anymore. I mean, he swung at him. And on top of that, this man had audacity to not only yell at his wife in front of Rick, but the fact of him hitting his wife in front of Rick, like, Rick is just way too unstable for that joint. His fuse went off, but I think what was so crazy is that the boat that was in the water with the red balloon, I don't know the exact semblance of it, but what resonates with me is that Rick keeps going back to how they had to live. And he can never forget it because his guilt, his pain, and then this trauma that's added with it. And then, and for a second, I mean, he could probably go back to when he bit the dude's neck or when he went and just lost it and had to fight his way through tons of walkers and killing his best friend. I mean, there's no telling. And so he was looking at that red balloon on that boat. Those two objects to me don't fit. And so it might be to me that, okay, I think at a certain point the balloon did set off, and it's like, okay, this is the disconnection. Even though this balloon and this boat, which I think the balloon is representing of Rick and who he really is and his group, and then the boat is just this thing anchored down to try to like tread water. But at a certain point, like, it's all gonna pop off, and that's what ended up happening in this episode. So it was really cool, really good episode. I gave it a 9 out of 10. I really enjoyed it a lot more than the last one, just because of what happened with Noah. But yeah, definitely check it out. You should be looking at it on amctv.com. If you have Xfinity, if you got the Xfinity app, Xfinity Go, you can check it out there. If you like this review, please leave a like and definitely leave your comments below. I'm not going to do any more spoilers on it. I thought I was, but George walked in, so I'm not going to spoil him. And yeah, let me know your thoughts about this episode yourself, if you liked it, and if you anticipate what's going on next. I'm about to go look at a preview for the next episode. And yeah, this was my review of The Walking Dead, episode 15. What was the name of this again? I don't even think I said it. I'm sorry, y'all. I'm sorry. I think I'm getting tired. It's like 12:30, and I kind of was feeling a little bit bad earlier, so I took some medicine. But the episode name, ironically, is Try. Episode 15, Walking Dead. So next week is going to be episode 16, and that is Conquer on the 29th. So be tuned for that, because I think the night of, I'm going to try to review. It's really hard, because Joe's not caught up Walking Dead, so I can't do the review right on that same exact day, but I'm going to try to if I can. All right, y'all. SEO 0320 signing out. Prepare to be shot if you ain't seen it yet. Later.